Good afternoon, good afternoon, good afternoon, and welcome back to 10 Minute Spiritual Word right here on Kingdom Purpose TV. I am so excited to see you back with me, and thank you to all of the support in the last 3 weeks. This is the fourth week, how about that, since we started this 10 Minute Spiritual Word. And I pray that you all have been really blessed by this 10 minute break in the afternoon. Amen, amen. Praise the Lord, and happy after Thanksgiving to you all. I pray that you all had a blessed Thanksgiving with family and friends, or and just being able to be able to commune and to fellowship with your family. It's been a long time coming, and if you were just at home like I was, just enjoying some rest. But thank God for his thankfulness for God, and I'm so grateful to him every day, for every day is Thanksgiving. How about that? Amen. Praise the Lord. We're going to go ahead and go into a word of prayer, and then we will go into the word of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Dear Heavenly Father, we just glorify you for yet another day you've allowed us to see. We thank you for your mercy, and we thank you for your grace, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, for yet another day that we've never seen before and we will never see again. So God, help us, Lord God, to be grateful for this day, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for the gift of life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, for yet another time to come together to just be able to just expound on your word. And Lord God, we just thank you, Lord God, for those that are listening in on today and tuning in to Spiritual Word with Tamala Colmen. I pray that somebody would be blessed today. I pray, Lord God, that you will lead and guide and order our steps today. You will continue, Lord God, to bless and keep us, Lord God, for we living in a time, Lord God, there's dark times right now, Lord God. And we all need to know that, God, you are love, and you love us unconditionally, Lord God. And we bless your name for just loving us, oh God. We just praise you, God, today. We give you the honor and we give you the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Praise God for yet another week right here on Kingdom Purpose TV. And today's word today will be coming from John 3:16. Hallelujah. One of my favorite scriptures from the New Testament. And we will read from John 3:16, and it reads, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved." Hallelujah. I went over and expound over to verses 17 as well. And today I would just like to expound on God's love. How many of you out there know that God loves you? I was thinking about this verse today, and I was just thinking about how God gave his only begotten son for the world, for him. Mankind, to let us know that he loves us with an everlasting love. And there are many people that are surrounded in this world. You know, we might know many people in our family and our circle of friends. You know, they question God's love. And I've had a couple of people to ask me, how do you know that God loves you? Well, first of all, he gave his only begotten son for us. And we must believe that. That's a part of salvation, is to believe that God gave his only begotten son, and he went to the cross, he died, he hung and he died. But thanks be to God that he's right now a living God. Right now, Jesus is living and he's sitting on the right hand of the Father. So we thank God for his love. And secondly, he woke you up this morning. When you look at your surroundings, you just look at what God has created. We are his creations. Hallelujah. We are his creations. And when I think about, you know, just everything that God has done for us, and you know, it doesn't have to be materialistic things, it doesn't have to be your money, it just that he just loves us with an everlasting love. And there are many people that are walking around, I started thinking about that, people that are walking around and don't feel loved. They feel like they've been outcast by family members. You know, they don't have anyone that really they can really depend on, or anybody that really can express their love to them. And believe it or not, there are people walking around like that. But I just thank God for God's love. And if there's anybody out there right now, and you're feeling like God is, you know, nobody loves you or nobody cares for you. That's one person that you know that loves you with an everlasting love. And that is our God, our Father. Amen. And there's nothing like God's love that lifts our spirits and comforts us, comforts our hearts when we are feeling down. You know, that's better than just knowing that we are loved and cherished by God. Amen. God loves us. God's love for us never changes. His love never changes. And I just want to let somebody know today that because God loves us, he gave his only begotten son. And I just to think about mothers and fathers, who can really say that they would give their son, their only son, or their only child as a sacrifice for somebody else? Can you really honestly say that you would do that? Well, God did it. And he did it for you and I. He did it for us because he loves us so much. And because Jesus went to the cross for us, we have the right to the tree of life. We have, we now can look to the kingdom of heaven. And after this time is over, we can have heaven on earth right here. But at the same time, we know that God loves us so much that he died for all of us. He died for our sins. He died for our illnesses. He died that we may be delivered, set free and delivered. Hallelujah. Thank God for Jesus. Amen. Thank God for Jesus. And his love is everlasting. There's nothing like the love of God. And the scripture that tells us, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son. And guess what? All we got to do is believe it. All we got to do is believe in him and believe, and we should not perish, but we will have what? Everlasting life. Hallelujah. Thank God for everlasting life. It was already done before the foundation of the earth. But we thank God for the world. We just thank God for his love for us. I wake up every morning. I thank God for just being able to open my eyes every morning. I thank God for just being able to see a brand new day that I've never seen before. I thank God for the breath that I breathe, because you all know that the breath that we breathe is of God. Amen. He created this body. He put breath in this body. So we're breathing his air. Hallelujah. His love. That's his love right there. You wake up every morning. You're able to walk around and you have activity of your limbs. You're able to walk around. You're able to, you know, just do the things that he created you to do. And if you're not able to do it, you're able to just thank him and praise him and give him glory and honor for just another day. Hallelujah. Another day. This is another day. Today is the day that he has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. God's love. God loves us. He loves you and I so much. And if somebody out there that's feeling doubtful, you're feeling like there's nothing, no way out, and you're feeling like there's no love, look to God. Look to God, who is love. God is love. He is everything that you need. He's everything that you can hope for. He's everything that you can dream about or imagine. He's even more than that. God's love is everlasting. He loves you and he loves you. And sometimes even when we are unlovable, how about that? When we're unlovable, amen. There are a lot of unlovable people walking around today. Unlovable. I don't care how much you show, how much you love them. They still try to block that out. But you know, keep showing love. And that word is today. Keep showing love. Keep showing love to those around you. Let them know that you love them. Call somebody that you haven't talked to in a while. Just let them know that you love them. You've been thinking about them. You've been praying for them. Just let them know that God is love and God loves them with an everlasting love. And guess what? Because he loves you, I love you too. And everyone, you have a great, great, great rest of your day. God bless you. And remember, God loves you. Hallelujah. Bless his name. Amen. Amen. We'll see you next week. Same time, same place. God bless.